Hello and welcome to a fresh episode of Tech This Week, where we bring you up to speed with the most important weekly developments in the enterprise and emerging technology space in India. In today's episode, we discuss mobility startups as they convert their existing fleet into electric, Niti Aayog's white paper on fantasy sports regulation in the country, an IPO flurry as four Silicon Valley companies list in about 24 hours, and finally, India's largest IT exporters as they invest overseas. I'm Supriya Roy, and joining us from the Tech Circle newsroom are my colleagues Kunal Talgeri, Dabangana Ghosh, and Payal Ganguly. Hi guys, 2 weeks into Christmas. Payal, how cold does it continue to be in the capital city? See all the blankets and everything's up.
It's not a blanket, it's a shawl. And yeah, secondly, it's kind of cold because there was no sunshine. So it's like we're stopping short of a white Christmas here.
Yeah, only the snow is lacking. Let's begin with the week's recurring theme that we at Tech Circle here have kept track of. Earlier today, ride-hailing startup Ola announced the appointment of a new director of its go-to-market strategy for its electric vehicles business in Europe. Now, the company is gearing up to bring the first of its range of electric scooters to Europe in the coming months. Julian Giffard brings over 15 years of deep automotive experience spanning across companies such as Peugeot, Bentley, BMW and Fiat Chrysler. Ola looks more serious than ever to go eco-friendly.
Absolutely, absolutely. Earlier this week, we saw that Ola said that it's going to help New Zealand's public sector become a carbon neutral country by 2025. So even if we take a look closer home, how do you see the entire ecosystem readying up?
Yeah, there's the manufacturing, the charging stations. No, the bit about scaling the country's infrastructure to take on these EV ambitions.
Well, if you look at all the announcements that were made this week, Supriya and Devangna, the only announcement which was relevant from an India perspective is that the company is in advanced stages of setting up a manufacturing unit in India, which will have a capacity of making up to 2 million vehicles a year. With the acquisition of the Dutch EV bike maker Etergo this year. If you remember, this was announced earlier this year. Also, what has happened is, interestingly, the company has kind of seen a restructuring in terms of top deck and leadership. Earlier this year, somewhere around June and July, the co-founder of Ola Electric, Ankit Jain, quit, followed by their chief business officer, Sanjay Bhan, who left in July. So looks like after raising $400 million, the company seems to have undergone a rehaul.
The bandwagon gets heavier. Dockless bike rental provider Bounce said it plans to firm up its EV strategy for 2021. Currently, electric vehicles form 50% of the company's fleet in Bangalore and Hyderabad.
Yet it plans to introduce 4,000 new EVs by February and achieve 100% EV fleet by 2021's second half.
Moving on, Niti Aayog and its CEO Amitabh Kant was in the news all week because he thinks India is too much of a democracy. Well, in quite the same vein, Niti Aayog came out with a white paper that advocates regulation of online fantasy sports platforms.
Yes, it's quite an emerging industry in the country, so to say, that features some of the really popular ventures like Dream 11, My Team 11, MPL, or like we call it, Mobile Premier League, Paytm First Games. And so there are a lot of them coming up nowadays. But fantasy sports contests don't have an independent legal recognition yet in India. So as of now, they are an undefined exception to the state gambling and public order laws.
That's right. The number of fantasy sports operators has increased by 7 times between 2016 and 18, according to a report from consulting firm KPMG last year. But the number of users has grown by over 25 times in around the same period.
By the same token, the Niti Aayog wants to protect consumers from unscrupulous online fantasy sports platforms. The KPMG report that Kunal cited earlier expects India's online gaming industry to touch revenues of 11,880 crores by 2023. The fantasy sports platforms are glad regulating the industry will bring an identity to these ventures, putting them apart or making them distinct from gambling activities that they're usually associated with.
From emerging sports platforms in India, let's cut to the US, where four tech ventures listed on the public markets. Supriya had a cool take on it that Tech Circle published earlier today. Supriya, what did you make of all that activity?
Yeah, so three of them listed on December 9. There was food delivery startup DoorDash, there was ad tech company PubMatic, and enterprise AI software provider C3.ai. And Airbnb listed the next day, which is 10th of December.
I remember visiting PubMatic 5 years ago in Pune and speaking with CEO Rajiv Goel around that time. They've been around for 12 years.
Wow. Speaking of Pune, though, fun fact, it's got 8 mentions. The city Pune has got 8 mentions in PubMatic's S1 filings to the SEC.
Deservedly so. It's been a good year for Pune startup circuit. Mindtickle closed a $100 million round from SoftBank last month. Dhruva became a unicorn in July following Icertus last year in the unicorn stable. And now PubMatic's marathon has meant an exit for its existing investors. People in investment circles I spoke with said this is a great period in the markets for existing investors to cash out. Valuations are soaring on the NASDAQ and private investors are averse to infuse capital in companies with very high valuations.
That's right. And moving on, closer home, looks like the IT exporters are yet to snooze into the winter with no pause to their overseas expansion plans for the coming quarters yet. But that's a good thing too, given the job losses. The world will have more jobs today than probably yesterday.
Yes, so HCL has expanded its footprint in the Southeast Asian market with the announcement to open business at Hanoi, Vietnam. The country's Ministry of Information and Communications had said that HCL plans to employ 8,000 employees in the business unit. And HCL is also organizing a virtual job fair this Saturday. So bang on, more jobs for the world.
What's happening with Tata Consultancy Services? TCS plans to invest over $100 million in Austin, right?
Right. So TCS will be opening a new facility by December end in Austin, Texas. The facility is going to have a capacity of 367 employees. And by 2022, the IT major plans to hire 130 employees in the city as a part of its plan to employ an additional 1,000 people in the state.
So in total, TCS currently employs 5,500 people in Texas and is present in 30 states across the U.S.
And with that, it's a wrap on this episode of Tech This Week. For more news and updates, log into techcircle.in. Be good, stay safe, goodbye.